Okay, so if you want to create a survey with Microsoft Forms, but you want to have it be dynamic and change based on the answers that are given to different questions, we're going to go over how to do that right now. So I'm just starting at forms.office.com, and I'm going to left click on a new form. We're just going to call this Music Program Customer Survey. And the point of this is going to be you're going to send it out to existing customers and you're going to find out what classes they want to take next. So let's add the first question and we're just going to make it multiple choice. We're just going to ask them if they're interested in taking another class. Now, this may not be the best sales technique, right? You may just want to start showing them the class options, but we're going to show this just to help you understand what the branching is that we're going to talk about. So Microsoft Forms is smart enough where it's suggesting some options, and they're right in that this is a yes and no question, but I wouldn't do at all because what we're going to do isn't going to have a response for maybe, so we'll add yes, and we'll left click on no also to add those two values to this multiple choice question. And the user needs to answer this for this to work, so we will left click on required. And we want this to control whether or not they're shown any more questions. But if we go to branching now, there's not enough questions to really have this make sense. So if they answered no, you could bring them to the end of the form. But if they answer yes, you want to bring them to the next question. So let's go back. We're not ready to do the branching options yet. We're going to add the next question. And let's make this a multiple choice as well. Keep this nice and simple. And we'll ask them which type of class they would like. We'll make it piano, violin, and you get the option here to add other, and this other is kind of a smart field where it's not just a radio button where you click it. It's going to give you a fill-in field if you select this option because it knows that other could be anything. But that's not actually what we want here. We want an other that's just a choice, another radio box that they can click, and it will bring them down to another question where they can give more detail. So let's make it another, but just not this other option that Forms is suggesting. And you'll see a little bit more on why that is later. So let's still hold off on the branching for a bit. Let's build this out. This is going to be the result that they choose piano. So we'll give them some courses to choose from. Beginner, intermediate, and again, there's some artificial intelligence going on here and it is suggesting that the next one be advanced. Let's accept that. That's a good answer. And then we also want to give some choices if they say violin. We'll just do beginner and intermediate for violin. We're leaving these as required, so the branching really works because you have to kind of flow through this form. Okay, so earlier we had the option where the user could select other. That's going to bring them down to this question. Then we actually have, let's say, courses for flute and courses for tuba, but that's in a big soundproof room because it's really loud, right? So tuba, and then the other option here we'll leave as what Microsoft Forms was trying to give us, which is just an input box. So here the user could type in if they have some other type of instrument, and you get enough people choosing that particular instrument, maybe you want to offer another course. So now that we have the questions done that are going to flush out what courses that they're looking for, we want to turn around and contact them. So we want to get kind of closure here. We're going to ask them when we want them to contact us and get some contact information from them. So there's a date field here that we can use that will only accept a valid date. So when you ask this question, the user will get a pop-up calendar and they'll be able to click a date. And if you happen to download this form into Excel later, you can sort by this date field. So we'll ask when would they like us to text you. And then we're going to get a text number here. So let's do this as just a text field. So they have an input box to type the answer into. We'll say, what's your mobile number? So they want to type in their phone number here. We'll do a little bit of data validation in case they type something that's not actually a phone number. So we're going to left click on these three dots, put in a restriction, and really what we can just do is say it should be a number. We could get a little bit more advanced, say it must be greater than, and then put some multi-digit number in there to make sure they don't just type in 23, but we'll just leave it as number for now. And so we have enough questions here to do our branching. So we're going to scroll back up to the top, and then we're going to go to the upper right-hand corner, do these three dots, and select branching. And let's just go from the top down. So if they say they're interested in taking another course, we've already selected next, if they say yes. But if they say no, let's just end the form there because they're not interested in any more courses. But if they're interested in piano, you want to bring them to the piano courses questions. If they're interested in violin, bring them to violin. And if they want to do something else, bring them to the other option. So if your user selected piano, they come down to this question and they answer beginner, then you want to get some contact information from them. So you say, when would you like us to text you? All of these are going to end up there. Same as the violin. And the flute. And then after they give you a date to contact them, you just go to the next question, what's your mobile number? And then we'll say this is the end of the form. So what this will do is this will end up giving your users a more streamlined experience, because if they're just interested in violin courses, that's the only questions that they're going to get. They can skip the rest of the form. It's going to increase your response rate because your users would be less likely to abandon the form. And then after you send it out, let's go back here. You'll just left click on the responses tab and be able to see all the responses that came in, or you could open it up in Excel to do some further analysis on it. If you want to see an overview of how forms works, you check out this video in the upper right hand corner. And if you like this video and you want to see more like it, you can subscribe in the lower right hand corner. Thanks.